accurate. And then when you read the scriptures, you'll read it as if every definition in there goes back to this English language. You don't want to get the root word and the root meaning of those words in there. Well, it's written in English. I know that. But you have to go to the Greek and the Hebrew.
So, you know, Greeks and Hellenists, they were Jews by birth that spoke Greek.
Yep.
Followed the customs.
And the reason why I said it like that, it's written in English, because that's how you simple ass niggas act. And then we come on this YouTube and through the spirit of y'all watch him out with shot and be aggressive, you weak ass niggas can't handle it. You weak ass niggas, man. That's why I can't wait. That's why I can't wait, man. You a bunch of weak ass niggas on this planet, man.
Yep, gotta do with language and customs, man. They speaking the language and doing the customs. They ain't had nothing to do with what they call nationality or race, because they was Jews.
Right.
They were Jews. So I got here in Acts 2 and 5. It says, and there were dwelling at Jerusalem Jews, devout men out of every nation under heaven.
That's right. So that means Israelites were scattered. You see? Devout men, meaning godly men, out of every nation, because Israel was scattered, man. Pursuing the James 1, the first chapter. You see? All right.
Verse 6. Now when this was noised abroad, and the multitude came together and were confounded, because that every man heard them speak in his own language.
Yeah.
And they were all amazed. They were all amazed and marveled, mm-hmm. saying one to another,
right.
Behold, are not these which speak Galilean?
Right. They were speaking meaning
are
they speaking
Galilean?
Yeah, speaking Hebrew, you see. But then they start speaking in other languages. Okay? Through the spirit of Yahweh Bashim Havashah. Alright?
And how here we every man in our own tongue wherein we were born.
See?
Western. Parthians and Medes. And Elamites,
mm-hmm.
and the dwellers of Mesopotamia,
mm-hmm.
and Judea,
mm-hmm.
and Cappadocia,
mm-hmm.
and Pontus,
yep.
and Asia, and Phrygia, and Pamphylia, and Egypt, and in the parts of Libya about Cyrene, and strangers of Rome.
See?
Jews and proselytes.
See? Now, proselyte meaning Israelite that's coming back to the truth. All right? So you don't get that shit. What is that proselyte? It's an Israelite coming back to the truth. Coming back to his nationality.
Okay.
Dang. Boy, you people, man. Hey, man. Hey. It's a lot of scatterbrains on this YouTube, boy. I mean, it's like they brains like scrambled eggs, man. Like mashed potatoes. It's all mushed up and all out of place. You see? So you got to tell them like that. That what that mean. That what this mean. Because if not, man, they just going to be looking dumb.
Got another example.
Yeah.
It says, this is John 19 and 18.
Right.
Where they crucified him and two others with him.
Right.
It's Yahweh Shai.
Right.
Either side one and Yahweh Shai in the midst.
Right.
And Pilate wrote a title and put it on the cross.
Right.
And the writing was Jesus of Nazareth, the King of the Jews. This title then read many of the Jews for the place where Yahweh Shai was crucified.
So, if they weren't speaking the different languages, how could they read what was written over him? Keep going.
Was crucified nigh to the city,
mm-hmm.
and it was written in Greek, in Salakia, Hebrew, and Greek and Latin.
So, if it was written in Hebrew, Greek, and Latin, that means Israelites were speaking Hebrew, Greek, and Latin. It's telling you in the scriptures the Jews was reading that. He just read it. Yeah. What?
This is Romans 2:9.
Right.
Tribulation and anguish upon every soul of man that doeth evil, of the Jews first and also of the Gentiles.
Yeah. So you know that them Gentiles right there are Israelites. And even when they say, well, what about when Paul say the Jews and the Greeks? That's Israelites. It's no different between the Jew and the Greek. That's the Israelite.
It's the language and the customs that they will follow. So it's got to do that.